So this week, we discovered that the New York Times newsroom has been having a problem with bed bugs. Now, this led to a lot of jokes about the fact that perhaps the New York Times journalists are actually the bed bugs in the newsroom. And one George Washington University professor actually tweeted that the bed bugs are a metaphor for Bret Stephens, who, of course, is a conservative columnist at the New York Times. Now, we can have a debate about how conservative Bret Stephens actually is, but the real story here is how Bret Stephens responded to being called a bedbug, which in the realm of internet insults is a relatively minor offense. I'm sure, as most of you have discovered on Twitter, you will get some pretty nasty stuff in your DMs for being a conservative. And I can say I've been called way worse things than a bedbug. But Bret Stephens was apparently so offended by this joke from the GW professor Dave Karf that he actually emailed this guy's boss. So he emailed Karf, CC'd his boss at GW University, and urged the professor to come to his house, meet with his wife and kids, and call him a bedbug to his face. Now imagine seriously writing, "Come to my house and call me a bedbug to my face," as if you're some tough guy. That is so embarrassing. And also clearly trying to get this guy in trouble with his boss for making a lighthearted joke on the internet. Luckily, George Washington University has no interest in disciplining this professor. But then Stephens went even further. He went on MSNBC the next day and complained that being called a bedbug is dehumanizing, and he likened it to things that people do in totalitarian regimes. This is a must watch.
I wrote him a personal email, which I think was very civil, saying that I did appreciate it, that I would welcome him to come to my home in New York, meet with my family, and see if he would call me a bedbug to my face. I also copied his provost on the note. People are upset about this. I want to be clear. I had no intention whatsoever to get him in any kind of professional trouble. There's a bad history of being called, of being analogized to insects that goes back to a lot of totalitarian regimes in the past. I've been called worse. I wrote this guy a personal note. Now it's out there for everyone to see.
All right, so we went from someone calling Bret Stephens a bedbug to Bret Stephens trying to get the guy fired and then claiming he wasn't trying to get the guy fired by CCing his boss, and then complaining that he's being oppressed and dehumanized by being called a bedbug. I mean, this whole thing is beyond parody. And the funniest part is that Bret Stephens is always talking about how there should be free speech and how even offensive speech is free speech. He talks a lot about speech culture on college campuses, and he's totally right. Offensive speech is free speech, no matter what people feel about it. But how hypocritical is it for him to turn around and try to silence this guy calling him a bedbug of all things because his thin skin can't take it? It's absolutely ridiculous. Plus, as anyone who has ever been bullied as a child knows, this is not how you respond to being called a name, right? This is just a guaranteed, surefire way to make the problem even worse by tattling and whining about it. And sure enough, Bret Stephens and hashtag Bretbug were trending on Twitter for the entire day, for an entire day this week because of his response to the whole scenario. And if he hadn't even responded to it, no one would have even seen this guy's tweet in the first place. So Bret Stephens is basically the idiot of the week for this one.